ओम नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो शिर्षिभ्यो महेभ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरेतः प्रज्ञान प्रत्यकर्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभूमसिष्टं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौड़पदं महान्तं गोविंद योगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशंकराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यान् अस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मुक्तिभेदविभागिने विमुक्तव्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारदीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मदीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तमरुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि यम हि कारुणिकं शरणं गत्वाप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्गमनन्तसुखाकृतिम् सो वी आर लुकिंग एट दि संभावना भाष्य So objection raised was, you yourself, the Siddhanti, says that there is no possibility of Atma being a Vishaya. Atma is not a Vishaya. Then that which is not a Vishaya is not Indriya Gochara also. And there is a Vyapti as to wherever there is Adhyasa Adhisthana, there is Vishayatvam as well as Indriya Sanyuktatvam. That is not there in the case of Atma, just because Atma is not a Vishaya. So it is not a Purovarti Vishaya. Therefore, Indriya Sanyuktattvam and Vishayattvam is not possible. Then how can it become an Adhisthana for Ahankaradi Adhyasa? There the answer given was in the Mula as to Natavad Ayam Ekantena Avishayaha. It is not that Atma is not a Vishaya at all. Atma is not a Vishaya the way you think it is a Vishaya. But it is not that Atma is not a Vishaya at all. Meaning Atma is not an object, but Atma is still known. So being known, it is a Vishaya. See, Vishaya in Sanskrit is a very loaded word. Need not necessarily mean an object every time. Vishaya can also mean a subject matter. So the subject-object division that you think of and thereby Atma being a subject is never an object, that much is true. But that kind of an objectness is not needed. Being an object is not necessary for becoming an Adhisthana of Adhyasa. So your Vyapti is wrong. This is what Siddhanti says. So Atma is a known thing, whether or not completely known, it is known nonetheless. Therefore, whatever is known can become an Adhisthana for Adhyasa. Thereby, Asmat Pratyaya Vishayatvat. How is it known? That is explained as Asmat Pratyaya Vishayatvat Aparokshatvatcha. So, both Atma is known as a Pratibimba in Antakkarana. Therefore, Asmat Pratyaya Vishaya, as Aham, Asmat Pratyaya, there is Aham Iti, known as Aham in the Antakkarana Vritti, as a Pratibimba, and also Aparokshatvacha means it is known by itself being self-shining, being Swayam Prakasha. And thereby Pratyagatma Prasiddhi, this is a Prasiddhi, everyone knows oneself. If you ask someone, do you know yourself? Nobody is going to say no. Even if one says no, what he means is that I do not know the Atma completely, but still one says that. that I itself, that I do not know who is that I. If you ask him, I am this person. So he knows himself as a person. That is an add-on information. But there is no confusion as to whether I exist and whether I am conscious right now. Therefore, nachayam asti niyamaha purovastita eva vishaya vishayantaram adhyasitavyam iti. There is no such rule as to the adhishthana of adhyasa should be indriya gochara. So, purovastita means indriya gochara, indriya sanyukta. There is no such rule that the indriya should be connected. Why? Because akasha is apratyaksha. Indriya is not connected to akasha, meaning indriyas are not the reason, not the pramana for akasha to be known. And apratyaksha pi akashe balaha. Balaha are those who are not viveki, avivekinaha. They superimpose talam malina ityadi. So talam malina tadi adhyasyanti. They think that the akasha has a dome shape. They think that it is dirty when akasha is asanga, cannot be dirty at all. Evam aviruddha pratyagatmani api anatma adhyasaha. Therefore, there is no virodha when one says that there is adhyasa, ahankara adhyasa, ahankaradi adhyasa in pratyagatma. So with this background again, because this bhashya should be set in the mind, so that the switch will be easier from vyakhya to bhashya. So in the vyakhya we were looking at asmad artha chidat asmad pratyah. So asmadi tatra hetum ah ayam atma niyamena avishayo na bhavati. Atma is not an avishaya. What does it mean? Atma is known. Tatra hetum ah, why is it not an avishaya? Atma is not avishaya. Why so? Tatra hetum ah, the reason is because asmaditi, it is known asmad pratyah. What is that? Asmat pratyaha aham iti adhyasaha. Asmat pratyaha is aham, known as aham. Asmat means aham. It will decline as aham. So aham ekaha manushyaha asmi. In that vritti that takes place, that is itself an adhyasa. You cannot deny adhyasa and you cannot say that I do not know. I do not know myself. You know yourself. Additionally, you know something else. That addition is an adhyasa, and thereby aham is fine as soon as aham vritti is a vritti where one thinks of oneself as a manushya. That is an adhyasa. Tatra bhasamanatvad ityartha. So asmat pratyaha aham iti adhyasa. Why? Tatra bhasamanatvad, not tatra bhasamanatvat is tatra antakkarane antakkarana vrittav. In the antakkarana vritti, there is aham iti bhana. Bhasamana is that bhana which is there. Aham asmi, aham bhami. So that chaitanya swarupa of yourself, you know by yourself. In the vritti itself, you know. When you think of yourself as I, in any sentence, in any vichara, when there is an aham vritti, there is definitely an aham vritti. We saw even in unrelated, there is aham known. Devadattaha ghatam pashyati, there also aham is known. It is evident. There is a pratibimba of aham in ahankara. In that antakkarana which plays the role of ahankara, there itself there is bhasamanatvam. Atmanaha bhasmanatvam, mama pratyagatmanaha bhasamanatvam. That is there. Thereby, it means what? Ayamatma niyamena avishayo na bhavati. Meaning it is a vishaya, it is known. I am known as aham in the asmat pratyaya. And second meaning is what? Asmat pratyaya aparokshatvacha. Asmad artha chidatma. In the first meaning itself, how is it known? Asmad arthai chidatma, it is swayam prakasha. But in aham pratyaya, how is it known? Pratibimbitatvena. As being reflected, the Brahma Atma, Brahmatma is as though reflected in the Antakarna. In a Shuddha Antakarna, it is clear to know. But in an Ashuddha Antakarna also it is reflected. And then there is a mix-up as Manushyatvam, Pullingatvam, all these come in as additional noise. That is Adhyastha. Yatra Pratiyateso Asmadartha Chidatma Pratibimbatvena Pratibimbitatvena Yatra Pratiyate. Yatra Antakarane Pratiyate Vrutta, in that Vrutti Asmat Pratyaya is a Vrutti. Pratyaya is a Vrutti. Asmat Pratyaya, the I thought, I cognition. In that there is Pratibimba of Brahmatma, which is my very Swarupa. However, I do not know unless I am taught. So I know myself as whatever it tags along with. Wherever it is reflected, there itself there is a confusion, just like the sun shining, not a sun, let's say, maybe the sun, which is reflecting in a very clean window somewhere or very clean mirror somewhere in at a distance. High up in the apartment, let's say you look at a reflection. The sun rises in the east. You do not know the direction that you are facing, but something shines forth at the top of the building. You cannot differentiate whether it is in the building because it's the last apartment in a high-rise window, high-rise apartment. It's a last apartment and the window, the corner apartment, and you see the sun shining. It happens to be the west, however. There is still a possible confusion as to that being the east. Why? Because the sun shines, you cannot even directly look at it. What has happened there is that this sun in the east is reflected off the east facing window on your west. It is east facing. To you, it is the west, western direction. But still, there can be a confusion that, oh, this is where the sun is. At a great distance. So thereby, what happens is that there can be a confusion with the Pratibimba as being yourself. Now that may be a Bhranti, but still Aham is known. You cannot say Pratyagatma is not known one way or the other, not a Vishaya at all. Therefore, Asmadartha Chidatma, that Chaitanya, which gives the bhana of Antakarana itself becoming sentient, the buddhi becoming sentient, the eye cognition itself coming up alive as though, that is due to the bimba. So, asmad artha chidatma pratibimbitatvena yatra pratiyate. Saha asmat pratyaha. That is asmat pratyaha. That is the eye cognition, the vritti, ahamiti. What is that really? Once it has become aham, the aham is individualization. So once you are individualized, that is the jivatva bhava, that is the ahankara. So ahankaraha tatra bhasamanatvad iti vartaha. So this is another meaning as to that is ahankara. Because in that ahankara, the individualization has taken place. Why has it taken place? Because of the Bimba shining there, Bimba Atma shining there, just like the sun reflecting there. Now, when the sun moves a little, in the same example that we are looking at, if the sun moves a little and then it reflects into the second window, another window which is very clearly within the apartment, then you are no longer confused. Then you know that it is a reflection because the sun is seen in the apartment. It cannot be in the apartment. Unless, you know, it is a see-through, there are two windows and you are seeing through and there is a sun behind, that can be the east as well. Through and through the apartment, I mean. There are two windows facing each other on the west and east side, and then you see through and there is sun on the other side of the apartment. That can still be the east. But then there is a possibility that you have seen the sun on the right side. Now you are seeing within the apartment and you think that now I know it is not the east, it is reflection. So it is the west that I am facing. So here in this exemplified, saha asmat pratyaya ahankaraha. In ahankara there is chidatma, brahmatma, prakasha, pratibimba, tatra bhasamanatva itivartha. So it shines forth in the ahankara, and in ahankara it is known. In that aham buddhi it is known. Nacha adhyase sati bhasamanatvam tasmin sati saha iti parasparashraya iti vachyam. So now there is a purvapaksha to it. Adhyase sati, when there is an adhyasa, bhasamanatvam, then only you know yourself. Why? Because aham iti, what have you said? Aham iti adhyasaha. Aham is an adhyasa. When the adhyasa takes place, aham iti, in the ahankara, in the aham buddhi, aham pratya, then you know what? Then you know yourself, atma, bhasamanatvam. Then atma is known. And tasmin sati. Tasmin sati is bhasamanatve sati. When the I is known, aham is known, atma, tasmin sati saha. Saha is adhyasaha. So when the adhyasa is there, then atmabhana takes place. And when atmabhana takes place, adhyasa takes place. This is a mutual dependency. So thereby anyonyashraya or parasparashraya. Same thing. Anyonyashraya or parasparashraya is a mutual dependency. So you know adhyasa. Only when adhyasa takes place, you know yourself. And as and when you know yourself, there is adhyasa. So this kind of a dependency is an anyonyashraya dosha, parasparashraya dosha. Mutual dependency is a dosha. So you tell me, what is the sequence? After adhyasa takes place, do you know yourself? Or do you know yourself and then you don't know yourself completely, whatever? Then there is an adhyasa. What do you really mean? Ask the Purvapakshi. It can't be both. You can't say, yeah, there is mutual dependency. It's a dosha. Iti nacha vachyam. You should not object like this, says the Siddhanti. You should not raise such an objection. Why? Anadityat. Adhyasa is anadi. We have seen this earlier. We have seen elaborately as to how adhyasa takes place sequentially. When is the mutual dependency? When the same adhyasa and the eye cognition which has taken place, they have, each unit of that has dependency on each other. Only when adhyasa one and aham pratyaya one, the eye cognition, when aham iti bhasamanatvam, so that has a dependency on each other, only then you can say it is a paraspara ashraya dosha or mutual dependency, defect of mutual dependency. But if it is sequential, if there is adhyasa one and then you have a cognition of aham, aham iti bhasamanatvam is there, which is, we'll say, bhana one. So when bhana one takes place based on adhyasa one, but based on bhana one, adhyasa two takes place, that adhyasa two is different from adhyasa one, then there is no mutual dependency. Then based on that adhyasa two, there is bhana two, aham iti, I know myself. In that, aham pratyaya, asmat pratyaya. Then based on bhana 2, there is adhyasa 3. Then there is no mutual dependency at all. It is like the bijankura nyaya. The same bija is not born from the ankura from which it came. The tree comes from the seed, and the tree gives rise to seed, but the seed which has come from the tree is not the same as the seed from which it is born. So there is no mutual dependency there. And it is pratyaksha siddha. Nobody objects to this kind of a thing. It is pratyaksha siddha. You see the seed coming off the tree, and you can plant that seed and you can see a an ankura and then it can grow into another tree. That tree is different from the first tree. So it's a sequence. Anadityat. This adhyasa is anadi. So purvadhyase. Purvadhyase. This should be adhyase. Purvadhyase bhasamana atmanah. Uttara adhyasa adhishthanatva sambhavat. So adhyasa is anadi. It has always been there. In the earlier adhyasa, there is atma bhana. And the uttara adhyasa, the other adhyasa that takes place, for that, this bhana of the atma, that atma which is known there, that becomes adhishthana. So uttara adhyasa adhishthanattvam kasya? Atma bhanasya, that atma which is known in that bhana. So aham iti bhasamanattvam, which is there, that bhasamana atma, which is bhasamana where? In the earlier adhyasa. So in the earlier adhyasa, earlier also there was an adhyasa. So there I know myself, and in that myself there is ahankara adhyasa again. That adhyasa is not same as the earlier adhyasa. There is a new adhyasa now. Uttara adhyasa adhishthanatvam. I know myself in the earlier adhyasa, earlier ahankara vritti, ahamiti vritti. And now, once I know myself, on myself, there is another ahankara adhyasa. That adhyasa, ahankara is the same, all right, but then adhyasa is new. In this adhyasa, again, I know myself, and then that I know becomes an adhishthana for the same ahankara being adhyastha again. Again and again, we make the same mistake. It continues across days, across vrittis, across days, across weeks, months, years, janmas, and it has been so anadikalena. Nanu, aham iti ahankara vishayaka bhanarupasya atmanah bhasamanattvam katham. Now there is a fundamental question. How do you say that this atma bhana takes place? So nanu, the Purvapakshi asks, aham iti ahankara vishayaka bhana rupasya atmanah. The atma in this asmat pratyaya that you talk about, asmat pratyaya tatra bhasamanatvat, tatra ahankare. In that ahankara, you know yourself, you are saying pratibimbitatvena. But the fact is what? Asmat pratyaya, that ahankara is a vishaya to that bhana. Bhana is jnana. So the jnana vishaya is ahankara, not the atma. How do you say atma is known in the ahankara vritti when ahankara should be known, not atma? So aham iti ahankara vishayaka bhana, that bhana jnana which takes place, you say I know. What do you know? You claim to say, claiming that I know myself, you know atma. Do you really know atma? Atma is not a vishaya there. Atma is not a vishaya because ahankara vritti is that jnana rupa vritti which is taking in the ahankara. The ahankara is the vishaya there. Thereby atma is not known, ahankara is known. If that be the objection, then atmanaha bhasamanatvam nasti eva. This is the objection. Aham iti ahankara vishayaka bhana. So bhana is, so this ahankara, aham iti pratyaya, that pratyaya is ahankara vishayaka, meaning ahankaraha vishayaha yasmin bhane tad bhanam ahankara vishayaka vishayakam bhanam. So aham iti ahankara vishayakam bhanam tadrupasya atmanah. So that kind of a bhana where ahankara is the vishaya, in that atma cannot be known. You can at the most say ahankara is known. How can you say atma is the vishaya, ahankara is the vishaya? Thereby ahankarasya bhasamanattvam natu atmanah bhasamanattvam. thereby this is akshepartha katham nasti ityartha na sambhavati. So atmana bhasamanatvam katham tad vishayatvam vina, and then if atma is not the vishaya, ahankara is the vishaya, then thereby what tad vishayatvam vina, atma vishayatvam vina tat phala bhaktva ayogat ityatah. Can there be a phalita to that? Can there be any atma vishayatvam is not there, meaning atma is not a vishaya in that bhana, ahankara is the vishaya, then the tatphala bhaktum, the tatphala bhaktum which you have said earlier, you said that atma is known, phalita jnana, the resultant of that jnana, the resultant of the adhyasa, phalita is this pratibimbitatvena phalitam, and then you know yourself. How can that be? That cannot be the phala. You cannot have the resultant as your own self as a result of ahankara being known. That can't be true. Thereby, jnana rupasya atmanah. What is the objection really? See, asmad artha chidatma. And really, atma is that bhana rupa, jnana rupa. Because you said chidatma. Chidatma, chit is what? Jnana. That chit is not known. What is known is a chid vishaya. And chid vishaya cannot be atma itself, which is chid rupa. What is it then? It is ahankara. Ahankara is the vishaya. Then how do you say atma is known? Thereby, atma being known cannot be the phala. So, tad vishayatvam vina. If you say ghata jnana is there, in the case of ghata jnana, what happens? Ghatam aham janami. There, the ghata is vishaya to jnana. And then you say, I know the ghata. That you pramata is different from the pramana jnana vritti, and ghata is the vishaya, which is also different as a prameya. So you can say that I know this ghata, which is the vishaya to the jnana. Jnana vishaya there is ghata. So bhana vishaya is ghata. Ghata is known. Similarly here, bhana vishaya is ahankara. Ahankara should be known. And the bhana itself is chaitanya rupa. You are saying that chid rupa. So that chid rupa atma is not known there in the asmat pratyaya. So phalita in the example is what? Ghata maham janami, that ghata is known. Then you can say, oh, ghata is vishaya, known as a vishaya. So vishayatvam ghate asti. You can claim that in the example. In the exemplified, chidrupa atma is not known, the vishaya is ahankara. So you can say, ahankare vishayatvam asti. Ahankara is known, you cannot say that atma is vishayade. That's the objection. To that, the Siddhanti answers as to aha aparokshatvachaiti. Okay, if you do not think that in the asmat pratyaya it is known, then swaprakashatvena. Sakshivhasya. Ahankara is sakshivhasya. So, this sakshi is swayam prakasha. You cannot have ghatadi jnana also without sakshi really. That sakshi manifests as pramata. With antakkarana and the vritti, there is some kind of an identification, and there we differentiate as to pramata is there, and that pramata knows the lights of the vritti, ghatakara vritti, and ghata as a vishaya is known. Sakshi is still there. However, in the case of antakkarana vritti itself being known, there is sakshi bhasyatvam. Sakshi is there, and that sakshi which lights up the vishaya is always known. Self-shining needs no other prakasha. Thereby vishayatvam. Vishayatvam means is not a vishaya you cannot see, meaning is not known, cannot be a claim, atma not being known, because sakshi is swayam prakashah. So aparokshatvacha iti, and then cha is used there, aparokshatvacha. Why cha? Cha shabda shanka nirasartah. So cha shabda has been used to say that there cannot be any doubt to this, because you, the purva pakshi, can you say that you aren't there? If I tell you you aren't there, will you say yes, I am not there? You know that you are there, you know you are conscious. I cannot get away by saying that, oh, you are blabbering, you are unconscious. Because blabbering means that some kind of consciousness is there, even if I say you are blabbering. So purva pakshi cannot say that I do not know whether I exist or I am conscious. That itself proves that swayam prakashatvam is there. Thereby cha shabda shanka nirasartaha aparokshatvacha, that cha is for showing that there cannot be any doubt at all regarding one's presence. So this is showing the jnanadhyasa also. Aham iti pratyaya swaprakashatvat. Now further, swaprakashatvacha ityartha. So aparokshatvacha means swaprakashatvat ityartha. Atma is aparoksha, pratyaksha. Pratyaksha also people say, sakshatkara. What is sakshatkara? Aham is known. When completely known, it is called as sakshat. It is known sakshat. Immediately, directly, without any mediacy, then it is called as sakshatkara. But we have this knowledge of ourselves with additional erroneous knowledge. So our knowing ourselves is always there. Additional noise is there, that's a different story. That's why the Vedanta Prakriya is Neti Neti Prakriya. It is unlearning what you know wrongly. It is not knowing something fresh. The knowledge works in the manner of taking away erroneous cognitions, erroneous understanding. Even in Mandukya Prakriya, Bhagavan Vashyakara says that even the in Mandukya, the way it is working is that even the Tattvamasi Jnana works in the manner that what you think you are not. So it's Neti Neti Prakriya all the way. And in Mandukya, it has said that, you know, there is no Karikakara. Bhagavan Karikakara says that there is no Jati, Ajati Vada or Ajata Vada. The Atma is not born at all. So what you think yourself as, I am born, I am a Baddha Jiva. When Mandukya says you were never born, what does it mean? You are there, you are never born, meaning you are not the Sharira Ityadi. So Neti Neti Prakriya there also. This is how Jnana works. So Swaprakashatvad Ityartha. Swaprakashatvam Sadayati. Now this Swaprakashatvam, Aparokshatvam has to be established. How do you claim so? So there Bhagavan Bhashyakara said Pratyagatma Ityadi. So he said, Pratyagatma Prasiddhehe. There is a Prasiddhi. Everyone knows oneself to be there and conscious as well. He explains that further. Abala Panditam Atmanaha Samshayadi Shunyatvena Prasiddhehe Swaprakashatvam Ityartha. How is Atma Swaprakasha? Abala Panditam. From a child to a scholar, need not be a well-learned pandita, can be a bala also. Even that bala knows that he is there, he exists, makes his presence known all the more so. The pandita claims so much of knowledge and with a lot of ego, with a lot of ahankara, claims that I exist, wants importance. The child claims so by crying. Why exist? Mother, look after me also. So the mother is busy, the child claims existence by crying out. Knows that it exists. So Abhala Panditam Atmanaha Samshayadi Shunyatvena Prasiddhi. It is very prasiddha. Very well known. Nobody says I am not there. So Samshaya is not possible. That's why the Vyakhyanakara said Samshaya Nirasartha. There is no Samshaya as to Aparokshatvam of Atma. Samshayadi Shunyatvena Prasiddhede. It is very well known through and through. Even if you say that I do not know, you know. You have not thought about it. A child may not be able to think, but knows that it exists. Knows that I exist. So, Svaprakashatvam Siddham Ityartha. Ataha Svaprakashatvena Bhasamanatvad Atmanaha Adhyasa Adhishthanatvam Sambhavati Iti Bhavaha. This is Sambhavana Bhashya. No, Adhyasa is impossible. That is what Katham. Katham in the beginning was Katham Punaha Pratyagatmani Avishaya Adhyasa Vishaya Taddharmana. Meaning, Asambhavaha Adhyasa Asambhava Ityartha. Sambhavana has been expressed by the Ataha, therefore. If nothing, Swayam Prakashatvam of Atma is Siddha, therefore what? It is known thereby Vishayatvam Nasti Itina, and therefore what? Svaprakashatvena Bhasamanatvad, Atma being known, Atmanaha Adhyasa Adhishthanatvam Sambhavati Iti Bhava. Atma can very well be an Adhishthana for Adhyasa. We are not saying right now that it is there. We are not saying that Adhyasa is proven. Pramana Bhashya will follow. But now you have to drop your impossibility and say it is possible. It may be possible. Likelihood is there. How it is so, we'll show. We'll establish that. But you cannot say impossible and run away. You have to listen to how it is possible. You have to give into the possibility right now. Now, Svaprakashatvad has been mentioned. What does it mean here now? As to the Vyapti which was mentioned. Look at the Vishayatvam in the case of Ghatapatadu. What was the Puropakshi's Vyapti? If we go back and look at Puropakshi's Vyapti, Yatra Aparoksha Adhyasa Adhishthanatvam Tatra Indriya Sanyuktatvam Vishayatvam Chaiti Vyaptihi. Shuktyadev Drishta. He is giving the example of Shukti Rajata. Shukti Ityadi are what? Aparoksha Adhishthana. See, what does it mean by Aparoksha Adhyasa Adhishthana? Let's say, first let's look at this Shuktyadi itself. In Shukti Rajatstala, Shukti Rajata is Aparoksha to you. Shukti should have been Aparoksha to you because it is right in front of your eyes. So this Aparoksha Shukti, which should have been Aparoksha, onto that there is Adhyasa of Rajata. Meaning Shukti is Adhishthana for Rajata Adhyasa, which is Aparoksha. So that Adhyasa Rajata, Adhyastha Rajata is Aparoksha to you. So it is an Aparoksha Adhyasa. It is Pratyaksha to you. It is not by listening to something. There, the Shukti Rajata is right in front of your eyes. So Tatra Indriya Sanyuktatvam, it is connected. Indriya is connected to Rajata, Shukti Rajata. We'll say Shukti Rajata because Rajata is nothing but Shukti. And it is also Vishaya. Shukti Rajata is a Vishaya of that Adhyasa, that Jnana. This is the Vyapti. In the case of Paroksha Adhyasa, what is Paroksha Adhyasa? Let's say you are sitting outside in a village home. Let's say you are on a vacation or somewhere, in a cottage, you are sitting outside, and inside, your relative comes out and says that there is a sarpa inside. Whether there is sarpa or a rajju, you do not know. Let's say there is rajju, and let's say your friend comes out and says there is sarpa there. So you have Adhyasa of Sarpa now. That Sarpa is not Pratyaksha to you. So it is not Aparoksha. It is paroksha. So that is a paroksha dhyasa. Their indriya sanyuktatvam is not there. Why? Because it is not purovastita, sarpa. Thereby there is no indriya sanyuktatvam. Is it a vishaya for to your jnana? Even if you say it is a vishaya because you see some sarpa, that sarpa is not pratyaksha to you. Therefore, vishayatvam may or may not be claimed, but indriya sanyuktatvam cannot be claimed there in the paroksha dhyasa. Now, if you take an example of not an adhyasa at all, because the objection is to the adhyasa, adhyasa is not possible. So, you look at ghatapatadhu. When ghatapatadhi prapancha is known, there what is the yogyata? So, yogyata which was talked about earlier and established there as to here. See, tad vishayatvam vina tad pala bhaktva yogat ityataha aparokshatva chaiti. There aparokshatvam was mentioned of atma. So, atma being known in some way or the other, that itself lets it a possible adhisthana, lets it become a possible adhisthana for adhyasa. In the case of non-adhyasa, when there is no adhyasa, it is a prama, prama-rupa jnana, prameya vishaya is known, ghatapatadi. There what happens? Aparoksha vyavahara yogyatvam is to be looked into now. So, this phalabhaktva yogat, can there be aparoksha vyavahara? So, aparokshatvam that you claim in atma, that can be comparable to, because it is pratyaksha, aparoksha is pratyaksha. And Purvapakshi is saying what? His objection was, atma is not purovastita like ghatapatadi, like shukti further. In ghatapatadi, let's say, there is no adhyasa, but in shukti which is purovastita, there is, like ghatapatadi, there is adhyasa. Ghatapatadi also have yogyatvam of aparoksha vyavahara. Shukti also has yogyatvam of aparoksha vyavahara. Atma does not have yogyatvam of aparoksha vyavahara as per the Purvapakshi. Why? Because it is not purovastita, there is no indriya gocharatvam, there is no vishayatvam. This was the objection. Now, if you compare with non-brahmasthala, ghatapatadau, or shukti also, shukti kadau, there vedyatvam is there. What we want to show is that this vishayatvam is what? Vedyatvam. Vedyatve sati aparoksha vyavahara yogyatvam. Ghatapatadau, in the case of ghatapatadi, vedyatve sati aparoksha vyavahara yogyatvam is there. Meaning, ghatapatadi are vedya vishayas and they are aparoksha vyavahara yogya. You can have pratyaksha jnana of ghatapatadi. So, indriya vishayatvam that you think of, that is possible in that case. Vedyatve sati aparoksha vyavahara yogyatvam. In the case of dharma adharma, dharma and adharma cannot be known. When you land on the atma, you can take all examples. So, what are yogya, what is not yogya. So, ghatapata is indriya vishaya, indriya gochara, indriya vishaya, vedyatve sati, and also known. So, vedyatve sati aparoksha vyavahara yogyatvam is there in ghatapatadi shuktyadhu. In the case of dharma adharma, dharma adharmas are not known with indriyas. They are not known at all. Are they known? Dharma and adharma are not known. I do not know how much dharma punya I have. I do not know how much papa I have. I know by the results and then I infer. Oh, I must have done this. This is my prarabdha. In my prarabdha, I have to suffer. I have all these health problems. I have these money issues. I have this, you know, whatever. Or, oh, my prarabdha is really good. I found a guru. I have a lot of money. I'm so rich. All this, I didn't do anything. You know, I was born with a silver spoon. Good prarabdha, bad prarabdha due to what? Good karma earlier. So, punya is there, dharma. suffering due to papa adharma. So I infer they are not pratyaksha yogya. So dharma adharma, in those cases what do I say? Aparoksha vyavahara ayogyatvam. They are not. So here when I talk about aparokshatvam, I can compare and contrast with how atma is aparoksha. What is aparoksha? What is not aparoksha? Ghatapatar aparoksha. Vedyatve sati aparoksha vyavahara yogyatvam. Aparoksha vyavahara is possible. I can know the ghatapata directly by myself. Dharma and adharma cannot be known. So avedya. And aparoksha vyavahara is not possible. Yogyata itself is not there. So dharma, 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 adharma, adi. Whatever is there in the antakarana, unknown. Vasanas, etc. Ragadvesha. Avedyatve sati aparoksha vyavahara yogyatvam. They are avedya also. And aparoksha vyavahara ayogya also. Aparoksha vyavahara ayogyatvam. In the case of atma, atma can be known. Atma can be known. Atma is not unknown. So, vedyatve sati aparoksha vyavahara yogyatvam. Atma also has. This is the aparoksha. And you, if you say avedya, you can say. As an object, you can say it is not known. So, there avedyatve sati is possible. But aparoksha vyavahara yogyatvam atmanah asti. Atma is aparoksha vyavahara yogya. Swayam prakashatvat. That is the aparokshatvam. So that swaprakashatvam or swayam prakashatvam was elaborated in that manner that even if you don't know it as an object, you still know atma as yourself, as self-shining atma, self-shining atma. And that was established by showing that even balas, all even balas, not only panditas, balas also know themselves to be existent and chaitanya, chidrupa. Okay, so that much is pramana, that is the sambhavana. So sambhavati iti bhavaha. Further, yaduktam aparoksha adhyasa adhishthanatvasya indriya sanyuktataya grahyatvam vyapakatvam vyapakam iti tatraha. So going back to the vyapti, vyapti khandana is done. The vyapti which was mentioned as what? Yatra yatra aparoksha adhyasa adhishthanatvam tatra tatra indriya sanyuktatvam vishayatvam cha iti vyapti hi, shown by Purvapakshi yaduktam. Purvapakshina. By Purvapakshi, what was said as what? Aparoksha adhyasa adhishthanatvasya indriya sanyuktataya grahyatvam vyapakam. The vyapaka there is indriya sanyuktatvam being connected to indriya and vishayatvam later. Grahyatvam. That is vyapakam tatraha. That is refuted by nachayamatsti niyamaha in the mula. There is no such rule as to it should be Purovastita. Purovastita means Indriya Sanyukta. There is no such rule as to Aparoksha Adhyasa Adhishthana should be Indriya Gochara. Tatra Hetumaha. And what was Hetru? Apratyakshe Api Iti. So Udharana is given and thereby Hetu is established. Even in Apratyaksha Akasha, there is Adhyasa of dome shape, etc. So that is explained here as to Indriya Agrahi api ityartaha. Indriya agrahi api akashe. Apratyakshe means that akasha which is not pratyaksha, meaning is not known through indriyas. Akasha is not known through indriyas. Even then it is aparoksha adhyasa adhishtana. So balaha adhyasyanti was mentioned. Bala means avivekinaha. Those who need not be only children, even grown-ups who do not think. They think that the akasha is dome-shaped. So, tala. Tala is what? Talam. Indra nila kataha kalpam. Navaha malinam peetam ityevam aparoksham adhyasyanti. Aparoksham. Do you think by yourself that do you infer, not infer also, do you see, if you say, what do you see? Oh, I see a dome-shaped akasha. Do you think so? Initially, yes, it is aparoksha. It appears to be dome-shaped, that there is no doubt that it appears to be dome-shaped to everyone. It appears blue, yes. It appears dirty also, malina. How so? When, you know, when they, in, say, Godhuli or something, you know, the cows are running and then the village side, the muddy roads, the mud is flying over and then the dust just appears in front of your eye, in akasha in front of your eyes. So this akasha out there, which is dusty, malina, it appears pita, it appears the muddy color. Is the akasha tainted? You cannot say the akasha there is dusty. There is no akasha there also really. So you can extend it. Akasha is limited in space, adhyasa. Akasha appears dusty, adhyasa. Akasha appears dome-shaped, adhyasa. Akasha is apratyaksha, indriya agochara. So indriya agrahi api akashe, tala malinatadi adhyasyanti balaha. Balas are avivekinaha. Those avivekis, those who do not have any viveka, they think that akasha has a tala, tala shape. So talam indranila kataha kalpam. So they see a blue dome-shaped structure. That is not true. And Nabha Akasha is Malinam. Malinam is what? Peetam. Appears brown or yellowish, dusty. Iti evam aparoksha madhyasyanti. That adhyasa is not paroksha adhyasa. It is not that someone says, oh, look at this. This Akasha is dome-shaped. Even before someone says, we see that it is dome-shaped. Someone doesn't have to tell us that it is dusty. We see dust in Akasha. We think that Akasha is dusty. Tatra indriya grahyatvam nasti iti vyabhicharatna vyaptihi. That vyapti that you have shown has vyabhichara dosha. There is vyabhichara. Why? I can show you an example where the akasha is apratyaksha. So aparoksha adhyasa still takes place without indriya gocharatvam and vishayatvam. So your vyapti has a vyabhichara. Tatra indriya grahyatvam nasti. Akasha indriya grahyatvam nasti. Tarhi अपरोक्ष अध्यास अधिष्ठानत्वम् अस्ति एतेन आत्मनात्मनोः सादृश्यभावात् न अध्यास इति अपास्तम् यू कैन रीड एन ए इत्यपि अपि कैन बी रीड देयर इत्यपि अपास्तम् सो विद दिस व्याप्ति दोष बीइंग शोन आत्मा एंड अनात्मा हैव सादृश्य हैव नो सादृश्य दैट काइंड ऑफ अ Objection is also refuted. How so? Nirupadika adhyase. In the nirupadika adhyasa, what is this adhyasa? Atma anatma adhyasa is ahankara adhyasa. In the case of ahankara adhyasa, the example given was shukti rajata. In the bhashya, it was said that loke anubhavaha. So earlier it was said, see, तथा च लोके अनुभवा शुक्तिका ही रजतवद अवभासते एकश्चंद्र सद्वितीयवदिति. The earlier example was निरूपादिका अध्यासा. शुक्तिका ही रजतवद अवभासते. शुक्ति रजता इज अ निरूपादिका अध्यासा. Whereas एकश्चंद्र सद्वितीयवद इज अ सोपादिका अध्यासा. इन दि शुक्तिका एंड रजता, शुक्तिका रजत स्थला, इंस्टेड ऑफ दि शुक्तिका द शेल रजत सिल्वर अपीयर्स. देयर इज सादृश्य एक्सपेक्टेड. पूर्वपक्षी सेज there is some similarity. What is that? Chaka chikyadi. It shines. So there is a shine in silver. So is there a shine in shuktika also. The shell shines. Silver shines. So because silver shines and the shell is shining like silver, you think that it is silver. You misunderstand the shell to be silver. Sadrusha is needed in the case of nirupadika adhyasa. Your claim in ahankara adhyasa to be nirupadika adhyasa, atma and ahankara should have some sadrishya. That is not true. Why? I've given you vyabhichara. In one case, that vyabhichara holds good in this example also, says the siddhanti. So, tatra indriya grahyatvam nasti. Tatra kutra? Tatra akasha indriya grahyatvam nasti. Tarhi, अपरोक्ष अध्यास अधिष्ठानत्वमस्ति बिकॉज तलमलिन इज अध्यस्त इन आकाश एंड इट इज एन अपरोक्ष अध्यास. सिमिलरली देर इज नो सादृश्य ऑल्सो बिटवीन आकाश एंड तल और आकाश एंड मल. वॉट इज दी सादृश्य? एब्सोल्युटली नो सादृश्य. आकाश डज नॉट हैव एनी सादृश्य विथ तला शेप, द डोम शेप और मला. देर इज नो सादृश्य सिमिलैरिटी बिटवीन डस्ट एंड आकाश. बट स्टिल इज देर एन अध्यास अपरोक्ष अध्यास दैट टू ऑफ तल मलिनतादि. यस, ब्लूनेस ऑफ द स्काई इज सीन देर. ऑल दीज आर पॉसिबल इन द केस ऑफ नॉट हैविंग सादृश्य एंड देर कैन स्टिल बी निरूपाधिक अध्यास. सिमिलरली इन द अहंकार अध्यास ऑल्सो नॉट हैविंग सादृश्य ऑल्सो अपरोक्ष अध्यास इज पॉसिबल. सो एतेन आत्म अनात्मनोः सादृश्याभावात् देर इज नो सादृश्य. इफ यू से लेट इट नॉट बी देर, वी आर नॉट सेइंग देर इज सादृश्य. वी आर सेइंग देर इज अपरोक्ष अध्यास. देर इज अपरोक्ष अध्यास अधिष्ठानत्वं पॉसिबल इन आत्म. तदपि अपास्तम, अध्यास कैनॉट बी देर बिकॉज सादृश्य इज नॉट देर. इट कैन बी देर. वाई? इन आकाश इट इज पॉसिबल, वाई नॉट हियर? संभावना इज देर. इन द एग्जाम्पल इफ यू एग्री देन इन द एग्जाम्पलीफाइड देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी. नील नभोः तदभावे अपि अध्यास दर्शनात् बिकॉज वी हैव सीन दिस नील. Blueness of the sky is adhyasa in the sky. The sky is not blue. But adhyasa is very well known there. And it is possible aparokshataya. Similarly, here also there is a possibility. Siddhante alokakara chakshusha vrityabhi vyakta sakshi vedyatvam nabasi iti jnyayam. So here in Siddhanta, what is said is alokakara chakshusha vritti abhivyakta sakshi vedyatvam nabasi iti jnayam. So akasha is sakshi vedya. How is akasha known in Siddhanta? If there be a question, you say akasha is not known through indriya. How is it known? It is sakshi vedya. The alokakara chakshusha vritti abhivyakta sakshi vedyatvam. The आकाश वेर दिस आलोक आकार इत्यादि. सो द लाइट आलोक इज लाइट ऑल्सो एंड वॉट इज इट एक्चुअली दर्शनम प्रकाश सति दर्शनम. इन स्पेस इफ यू कीप घटा, घटा इज नोन. साइंटिस्ट से दैट द लाइट दैट रिफ्लेक्ट्स ऑफ द घटा इज नोन. सो प्रकाश इज देर, आलोक इज देर एंड दर्शन टेक्स प्लेस. सो आलोक आकार चाक्षुष वृत्ति अभिव्यक्त इट मैनिफेस्ट चैतन्य. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट इट मैनिफेस्ट चैतन्य एंड दैट चैतन्य विच इज मैनिफेस्ट बाय द बाय एनीथिंग इन आकाश द आलोक आकार विच इज चक्षुग्राह्य. चक्षुग्राह्य इज प्रकाश ओनली बट थ्रू दैट देर इज मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ चैतन्य इन इन आकाश बिकॉज एवरीथिंग इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन आकाश एंड इन दैट मैनर आकाश इज रिवील्ड. साक्षी वेद्य, साक्षी वेद्यत्व नवसी इति नियम. नवसी इज आकाशे. संभावना निगमयति एवमिति. सो संभावना देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ अध्यास दैट इज कंक्लूडेड. भगवान भाष्यकार कंक्लूड्स बाय सेइंग एवम. Evam means what? Since no objection can be there, the asambhava dosha has been removed. The claim that adhyasa is asambhava has been removed by giving tarka, by giving examples. Therefore, evam. In this manner, there is possibility of adhyasa. Aviruddha pratyagatmani api anatma adhyasa. Anatma adhyasa, ahankara adhyasa is possible in pratyagatma. फर्दर तम एतम एवं लक्षण अध्यासम पंडिता अविद्या इति मन्यन्ते. वी लुक एट दिस इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. सो नाउ प्रमाण भाष्य स्टार्ट्स. this very adhyasa that we discussed is what is adhyasa. Adhyasa is what? Avidya karya. Since avidya is there, avidya karya, adhyasa is there. Adhyasa is anadi because avidya is anadi, avidya or ajnana. This avidya karya, adhyasa, is also called as avidya by scholars. So they consider adhyasa as avidya. Why? Because it is avidya karya. Ghata, which is mrinmaya, mrinmaya ghata, can be called as mrita also. So you say this pot is what? It is nothing but clay. Similarly, avidya karya adhyasa is nothing but adhyasa, nothing but avidya. So karya is known through karana also. The name tag of karana is given. The entire, you know, the family lineage is what? So they say that who is this? Is a Bhatta. Born in Bhatta family. So karana, the family name continues as karana. His father was a Bhatta, his grandfather was a Bhatta, and so on. So karana goes on and it is a name tag to karya also. So avidya iti manyanti adhyasam eva. So there is usage of the word avidya also, or understand as this itself is avidya in the case of adhyasa also. We'll look at the bhashya and vyakhyana further in the next part. Yamiha karunikam sharanam gatvapyari sahodara apamahatpadam tamahamashu harim paramashre janakajankam sakritim. Any questions? Namaste. See you next part.